Hey, bad buddies. I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy One. Let's do this in bite-sized chunks. I got a lot of fast, maybe a handful of bat buddies commenting on this project. And I'm gonna go ahead with it, but I'm gonna do just a little bit at a time. So I have a tactical belt that I'm working on. I haven't done very much, but think about it. I've got this thing where it goes in these and it comes out, and these are gonna have like little spikes attached to it. I've got one already that's like that right here. So this has a bunch of little spikes, and I have to get a better cord or some other mechanism or rope. But basically, if you throw it up somewhere, I'm trying this for the first time right now. Yeah, first catch. So what you have is a redundancy. You have enough spikes that, let me get this down. You have enough spikes that one is bound to catch. Now, if I could do welding, I don't have a welder right now. I used to have one. I would make a grapple hook for one of these. And I might still figure out a way to make a grapple hook. But this one's kind of cool because I took just what I have. You see, these are eye hooks, and I cut them all so they would grab on. Now, I've only mounted them on here with upholsterer's little wires, okay? So you're really not gonna hang on this, but it's kind of fantasy, and you could incorporate it with metal line or whatever else. I went ahead and cut that one, and I put those little things in there just to make it a little more sinister looking. That's as much as I've fooled around with the belt. But I'm pretty happy with my progress thus far on the spear gun out of the selfie stick. So let's take this apart and show you how it goes. Let's go up top so you can see this better. So just a quick look, and let's bust it apart. All right, so let's talk our way through this. All right, so this is a paint stirrer, okay? And it's all I've got for right now. I could bend this down. I could make these into little grappling hooks. I could cut them down and make them so they catch on things. Or, you know, have one be smaller in the middle and then the other one not be quite as small so that it's got a redundancy thing as well. So I'm thinking about doing that because I don't ever use it for paint stirring. So this is the selfie stick. I've taken this part off and put it on here. And this leaves this the way that it was underneath. And depending on what you like, you can make it go longer if you like the look of that. And you could pretend it's something else, like a gun. This is a thing like you use for sticking in like a liquor bottle. Let me get this out of here. I cut it off, but I put enough glue on there so it'll go in nice and tight. We'll make this go on down and I'll show you how it goes together. These are the knife holders from another utility belt. You saw the other day, I took the knives out and I put them in a pouch because I found a couple of leather straps on one of the last belts that I did. So I wanted to use these. I bought some blinds. Remember, I did the belts out of blinds. These are additional blind holders. They look junky right now, but when you do this all down in black and various colors, it's going to be subtle. I just had to buy a wiper for my car, and it's patent pending, U.S. patent pending. It even says on here, U.S. patent pending. And it has these various devices. Just about any kind of wiper car, it'll fit. So this one wasn't required for mine. I said, oh, I'll mark the time, you know? Home Depot, by the way, is a place to get your wipers really inexpensively, guys, if you didn't know. Made this little thing that spins. Now, it doesn't actually work. You know, it's some kind of spear gun, I think. So then you just put this in here like this, and you go in until it's kind of tight, and it'll hold in place. And then you can decide how far you want to make it come out. What do you think looks good for you? Maybe you just like it smaller. I don't know. And you can just put this in here at whatever length it is. And this is just something that I used. I could just glue this in or make it solid. But I thought, no, you know what? Let's use these knives. Because I got a whole drawer full of knives. I got to get rid of them somehow. And let's just use those to hold that in place. Kind of looks okay, right? I mean, it looks like knives right now, but it won't look like knives eventually. And I thought, oh, that's cool, because, you know, this is a long-range weapon. Once you fire, it's like a spear gun. You fire one time, and you're done. But somebody comes at you, you go, oh, no, I did my one fire. What do I do? I got two knives. So like I say, it's just like therapy for me. It's just for fun anyway.
But I like it when I'm sharing it with someone. That's what makes it even more fun, because otherwise I'd just be sitting here doing this all by myself. So what I really need is some other kind of thing down here still to hold it. I just got a kick out of this because this is a bicycle brake. This is a gate locking mechanism. This is a thing for a gate locking mechanism with that uses a lock. This is the other part of the wiper blade thing. I just took this old thing on here. I filed it down and put it on with some clips, not clips, cable ties. I just put this in here to make it look like something else because it kind of reflects this going the opposite direction. I just put this on top of this because this is bolted on and it looks ugly. You put that on there and it looks like, well, that's better. It looks better. So I got these things. I got to find a way to get this where it doesn't want to come loose. So I got to work out some of the kinks. This is just something to make it look like it's supposed to go through there. We don't know what this is, but I got another reflection of it down here below. That's basically where I'm at so far. This is just the top off of a super glue. And this is just to disguise the fact this is just one of these brushes that I shaved off the bristle. That'll look good once it's painted. And I just need, like I say, some other stock here. And it's way too big for a utility belt. But when you start off with a selfie stick, you know, it's pretty long as it is. It's already too big for a utility belt. So that's where I am so far, guys. Like I said, I just wanted to check in. We'll do this in little bite-sized chunks. If people are interested, I'll continue to make videos. If not, I'll just finish it up. I'll put it on my display and I'll just have some fun. So that's all I've got so far. Spent, I'd say, a couple of hours already working on this morning. But I haven't pulled with the utility belt out of the pants yet. But I'm always looking for things, so I went out and did some errands recently, and I just this morning picked up a nice little wood dowel rod that'll make plenty of dowels for utility belts and various other things. I got this really nice threaded rod. It's a light fixture, and it's really nice because my son, he broke his snake hook after 6 years, and I had made him a nice little case. Couldn't find that original one. So I went ahead, I fixed it for him. It's too late because he already bought another one. I couldn't make him a case out of the larger one. I made him a strap to wear it over his shoulder. It's a big heavy duty thing. And what I'm going to do now, while he's on these conventions, and he's kind of coming back shortly, I'm going to make him yet another snake hook that threads and can go in that original pouch. So he can take one or the other or both. And this will fit in that pouch as well. So all I need to do is just get something that will be the hook on the end of it, and I'll have that for him. So what to do with the old wiper? I was thinking of incorporating it into a rigid structure to incorporate into this high-tech tactical belt, but it's a little bit too rigid. I might be able to bend it, I'm not sure. Make it stay at the shape I want it to be. I don't know. Anyway, I'm fooling around with these things. It's too hot. It's 85 degrees. I'm done for right now. So I just wanted to check in, do a real quick video and show you where I'm at. And I think maybe the next one, if anybody's interested, I'll do the finishing on this because that won't take me much more than about 10 minutes to do that. So you get the whole spear gun made and finished in just a couple of hours. That's not bad. And a lot of junk and all for fun. Every spear gun you ever make is going to look different, all right? But they're all fun. And if you have a cave that you have these various things around that you make, I put these things on the end. I did a couple of foolish, crazy things, like took a Begins Batarang and added them to that one. Just fun stuff. I'm always fooling around with stuff. Yeah, I encourage you to fool around with stuff. Now you can buy stuff that other people have made, look like maybe came off a screen. Anybody can do that, though. And to the general public, they might say, oh, it looks so great, you know, and that's the end of the conversation. But if you're with some colleagues and whatnot, and you're talking to various costumers, they're going to come up and look at you and go, oh, how'd you do that? Where'd you get that? Well, I did it myself. And you'd start talking like that, and that's fun, too. So I've gone the whole gamut. In fact, I never did the one where I said I bought anything. I always made everything. So it's a lot more fun to say, well, I made it, and I'm costuming with it, and blah, 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 and this is what I did with this, and all that kind of stuff. So I encourage you guys, whether you're artists or not, to do what I'm doing in whatever regard you like to, because it's easy and you can do it. I put these things together for you in a way that I know your common layperson
with just a little bit of interest in crafting ability can do things like this and other things. Had a great suggestion. Somebody said make an entire bat suit out of spare parts. That's a huge job. I don't even have a bat suit currently. I don't have anybody to go costuming with. But somebody said, let's make a cowl out of spare parts. I think that's a good idea. And I think what I'm gonna do, I've been wondering what to do with all this black leather. I can take and cut this and surface coat a cowl in a very articulated way, and then put other things wherever the seams are to make it look like, oh, that was meant to be there. That was supposed to be a seam there. We're gonna cover it up with something. You know, I don't know what it is. And make it look tactical, but have the surface look really nice because it's all leather. So that's a nice idea that one of the Bat Buddies had. And I think I might actually work on that one because a cowl is much more manageable. I think all I'll do is take my base, one of my old base cowls, do it nice and thick so it holds its shape really well, and just start putting things on there and just having fun like I do with this stuff, but with a cowl. Thinking about doing that. So far I got 4 or 5 of you guys are interested in these things. Basically what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to say, hey, do you guys want me to keep on going down this line? I got about 4 or 5 people say yes. Anybody else know? Let me know. Thanks. I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy One. Talk to you later, buddies. Later.